Okay, once we finish it, the short run market supply curve, let's draw now the long run market supply curve. The same thing. We have here two graphs. On the left side, we have each firm's supply curve, that is the marginal cost, and the long run average total cost curve. And on the right side, we will represent the long run market supply curve. We know that in the long run, the typical firm earns zero profit. Why? The price equals marginal cost equals the minimum of the average total cost. Here, the minimum is represented by this line here, price equals minimum average total cost. Here, this price is represented by this discontinued red line. So here, at this point, it is the long run equilibrium supply curve, the long run equilibrium of the firm. Okay. The long run market supply curve is horizontal at price equals minimum average total cost. I remind you that this assumption that all firms are identical, this means that this firm all firms are identical, so they have the same costs, so they have the same minimum average total cost. So this one firm represents actually all firms, okay? Because they have the same costs and the same long run average total cost curve and the same marginal cost curve. So in the long run, the market supply curve is horizontal at the price equals minimum average total cost. So this horizontal line, red line, represents the long run supply curve. The question is why the long run supply curve of the market is horizontal. This is what we are going to explain and demonstrate in the coming slides. Here we go. So short run and long run effects of an increase in demand. So in the long run, in the short run, the demand curve is in one position, but in the long run, the demand changes. It increases sometimes, it decreases sometimes. So let's see what happens in the long run when the demand increases. So we begin, a firm begins in the long run equilibrium. So let's suppose the price is P1 and the equilibrium is represented by this point, it's called A. And each firm is producing this quantity of that maximizes its profit. And in the right side of the curve we have S1, the short run supply curve of the market, and D1, the short run demand curve in the market. The price is P1, so the quantity Q1 represents the quantity supplied by the whole market, that is equal to the quantity supplied by each firm times the number of firms. Sorry, here we present A, and here let's make it A prime, okay, to make a difference. Okay, the demand changes. There is an increase in demand. This increase in demand shifts the curve demand from D1 to D2. This red curve, the demand, this red line demand curve D2. The result is an increase in the price because the demand is now bigger than before. So the price becomes equals to P2. Obviously, the firms equilibrium becomes, quantity of equilibrium becomes now changes because the price has changes. So it is always the intersection between the price curve and the marginal cost curve. So the quantity change from, let's say, small q1 to small q2. Okay. So now our firm, each firm now is making profit because now the price P2 is higher than the cost. If the now the quantity produced is Q2, the cost of this quantity produced is, let's say it is here, and the price is, the new price is here. So as you see, the price P2 is larger than the average total cost for a quantity Q2, small Q2, and this makes the firm, each firm in the market, makes a positive economic profit. You'll see this rectangle with orange, with orange area. This area is positive, meaning that each firm is making profit, positive profit. Now the business becomes profitable because market conditions have changed and have improved. Other businessmen, other firms are looking, and they might seriously think to enter this market, and then many firms will enter the market because there is a free entry in this market. There is no cost. It is easy to enter this market at any time. So the business now is profitable. We are, those who are watching outside the market, they look to these firms and they find that they are making money, they are making positive profits, so they will be encouraged to enter the firms, the market. So new firms will enter the market over time, which will increase the supply in this market, and the increase in the supply will shift the short run supply curve S1 to another short run supply curve S2. And this shift in the supply curve reduce price, the price P. And the price P then comes to P1. It was for a short time, it was P2. Now it returns to P1. And the new, and each firm then now, each firm will come back to its previous quantity produced, that is Q1. Okay. And this reduction in supply and reduction in price, and the price P1, makes its firm coming back again to the situation of zero economic profit. Okay. P1. And the market, the new market equilibrium moves from B to C. See the intersection between the new demand curve D2 and the new supply curve S2. And the price in the market goes back to the price to P1. So if we join the two long run market supply points, a combination A and C, we get a curve, the long run supply curve that is horizontal, which is here the green line curve. Okay, so this is why I can say that in the long run, the market supply curve in a competitive market is horizontal. Because and the profit, each firm's profit is at this in the long run, each firm's profit is zero. Why the long-run supply curve might slope upward? This is because related to the assumptions we spoke about at the beginning of this, in the beginning of this three slides ago. If one of the assumptions is not true, so of course the whole analysis changes. So the long-run market supply curve is horizontal if all firms have identical costs, and costs do not change as other firms enter or exit the market. If either of these assumptions is not true, then the long-run supply curve slopes upward. Let's see, if firms have different costs, means that each many firms, the firms in, them, in this market, are not identical. As price rises, firms with lower costs enter the market before those with higher costs, which is very natural. If I have lower costs than you, I'm able to enter the market before you because the market conditions are in my favor. Further increases in price make it worthwhile for higher cost firms to enter the market, which increase market quantity supplied. Okay, if this new category of firms enter the market, because now the price is more in their favor than before, this will increase them for the market quantity supplied. Hence, the long-run market supply curve slopes upward. Okay. So here for two different prices, we have two different quantities in the market supplied, which makes the market supply curve slopes upward. So at any price, for the marginal firm means the last firm that entered the market. For that last firm, it belongs to the category of firms with higher costs. For that marginal firm, the price will equal its minimum average total cost, and it will have a profit equals to zero. But for the category of lower cost firms, because they have an average, they must have a minimum average total cost or an average total cost that is lower than the minimum average cost of the category of firms with higher costs. These firms, because they have lower costs, they will make positive economic profits. Okay? So this situation, when the firms have different costs, the long-run market supply curve will not be horizontal, but it will be a little with a small positive slope upward. Now, the second assumption. If the second assumption is not true, this means that costs rise as firms enter the market. For example, in some industries, the supply of a key input is limited. Example, amount of land suitable for farming is fixed. If I enter the new firm as well, the demand for this input will increase as the new firms enter the market, and the price of this input will increase. So this If the price of input increases, the costs will change. So the entry of new firms increases demand for this input, causing its price to rise. So this increases all firms' costs. There is a change in the costs because of the entry of new firms in the market. Hence, an increase in price is required to increase the market quantity supplied. So the supply curve is upward sloping. If the price changes, the market quantity supplied will change. This makes the supply curve not horizontal. One price for all quantities, but it will slope the different curve with a positive slope, because there will be different quantities for different prices. So a horizontal supply curve is not representing such a situation. Because a horizontal curve means one price for all quantities. In this case, in this situation, there are many prices for many quantities. Conclusion. In this conclusion, we talk about the efficiency of a competitive market. Efficiency is related to the welfare. Welfare means consumer surplus and producer surplus. And this consumer total, both surpluses represent total surplus. Total surplus is represent efficiency, and this total surplus is maximized when the competitive equilibrium is happening. Means that the price in the market is the price of equilibrium. Supplies, it is the intersection between the supply curve and the demand curve. When that is the price that exists in the market, we are sure that the market is efficient because it realizes its maximum total surplus. So let's see, how about, is competitive market efficient? Is the competitive market efficient? Let's see. In the competitive market, the firm can maximize its profit when marginal cost equals marginal revenue. In perfect competition, the price equals marginal revenue. So a firm maximizes in perfect competition, a firm maximizes its profit when price equals marginal revenue equals marginal cost. And we know in the competitive equilibrium that the price equals marginal cost. Why? Recall that the marginal cost is cost of producing the marginal unit. You remember from the chapter on markets and welfare that the marginal cost curve represents the marginal unit. Okay? And the marginal cost represents then the supply curve. And the P is the value to buyers of the marginal unit. Okay, and the P then it represents like the demand curve. So the competitive equilibrium is efficient because it maximizes total surplus. Let's see that in this graph. Here we have market equilibrium, two curves, the demand curve and the supply curve. At the equilibrium, when the market is in equilibrium, total surplus represented by the sum of consumer surplus and producer surplus is maximized. So here we have come to the summary of this chapter. So in this chapter we have seen the behavior of a firm in a competitive market. We said that A competitive market is based on three main assumptions. First, atomicity. There are many sellers in this market and many buyers. So atomicity. The second assumption is the product homogeneity, means all these numerous sellers are selling the same, exactly the same product. There is no difference between them. And the third assumption is that it is always free without any cost to enter this market and exit from this market. These three assumptions create what we call a theoretical market structure. We call perfectly competitive market. So in this type of market, we want to know what are want to know how firms behave in terms the decisions that the firm should make, can make. Of course, it is for-profit organization, so the firm should make the decision that maximizes its profit. Decision about what? About how much units the firm should produce. We call quantity Q, and what is the price to be charged for the customers. In this market, because there are many sellers in the market, so nobody has any influence on the price. So each firm should then behave passively and just take the price as it is, as it is applied in the market. That's why a firm in a competitive market is called price taker. So there is no decision about the price. It is taken as it is. No power to decide the price. I'm just a passive firm. I take it. I ask my fellow firms at the market, what is the price you are charging? They tell me what is the price they are charging. And just I just apply as it is. What I can do, the only thing I can do, I can decide about is the quantity of production, of output I can make. And of course, I should, you know, that the cost changes with the quantity. So, and it is the cost curve is U-shaped. So I should find the quantity that makes me making the highest profit. That quantity is determined according to a rule. For a firm in a perfectly competitive market, it should produce the quantity of output when or where the price equals marginal revenue MR equals a marginal cost MC, which both of them are equal to the average revenue. Average revenue for is equals to the marginal revenue and equals to the price. And these three terms, price, marginal revenue, average revenue, actually they are equal to the same. And the quantity that should be produced is the one in which the price equals marginal cost, MC. So the intersection between the price curve, which is the margin at the same as the marginal revenue curve, which is the same as the average revenue curve, is the intersection between this curve and the marginal cost curve. At this intersection, when marginal cost equals marginal revenue, the firm finds the quantity Q that maximizes its profit. If the price is larger than the average variable cost, a firm maximizes profit by producing the quantity where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. So, if the price is less than the average variable cost, here in the short run, the best decision the firm should make is to shut down its activity. So there will be shutdown in the short run when the price is below the average variable cost. In the long run, if the price stays for below the average total cost in the long run, well, the business is not profitable, and the rational decision, we are in economics, we always assume rationality of the individuals, firms, or consumers. So here the business is not profitable because the revenue for each firm, for each unit is less than the cost of this unit. Then the best decision, the optimal decision, is to exit this business, to exit the market, and seek maybe another market or another business. This is the decision rule in the long run. So in the short run, entry is not possible, and an increase in demand increases firm's profit. With free entry and exit, because if those who are outside the market, those who are watching these firms, and they find that they are able to make profits, and they know they can enter the market at any time without any cost, so the new firms will enter the market. This will reduce, of course, as you remember in the previous slides, we have seen the graph. The supply curve will shift to the right. The price will decrease, and if the price decreases, the profit will decrease until it becomes zero. Zero in the long run, and that is the long run equilibrium in the competitive market. In the long run, always. All firms in the long run, in a competitive market, in the long run, all firms must make zero economic profit. Because at this point, the price equals marginal cost, and equals the minimum average total cost. So it is the point where the curve of marginal cost crosses the curve of the average total cost. At this point, it is at the same time the point where the firm maximizes its profit, and that profit will be zero. So I have finished this chapter. Now the behavior. The firms in competitive markets. I hope it was clear, and thank you for your attention, and good luck, and see you in coming presentations. Thank you very much.